Hey guys, Mr. Divine here, back with a new video for Spartan Lights. Alright, today we're going to be covering some of the basic tips and hints for beginners in Spartan Lights. If you don't consider yourself to be a beginner, I suggest you skip past the first three basic points. So the first thing you should know in Spartan Lights is the basic movement and battle mechanics. Now you'd be surprised how many people didn't know that they can use shield bash and dash until they were a higher rank. Now these two things in particular can make your combat experience less stressful, but other than that, I would also like to mention the importance of using your sprite and charge attacks. A lot of people manage to forget they even have a sprite and don't use it to its maximum extent. The sprite becomes more and more important as it evolves, so I suggest learning to use it early on. Also, the usefulness of using charge attacks, especially when you are taking on harder missions. At a lower level, your charge attacks might not be so devastating, but they are definitely safer. You can keep your distance from the enemy and deal damage without taking any, with little skill needed. Now, for your sprite. If you haven't already chosen one, I would strongly suggest either going for the Drakon or the Seraphix. Not for the Masquerade, since it only truly offers an advantage in solo play. However, Drakon offers a more aggressive and high damage dealing play. Honestly, if you're a new player and you like staying alive as long as you can, I suggest choosing the Seraphix. It offers a good deal of attack and health support, especially in late game with its ultimate abilities. A popular question I get in Spartan Lights is also what equipment you should be getting. Now, here you can have your personal preferences, but honestly I'd suggest the first build to be from Skulver Armor and Divine Veil Helmet. Why? Because it offers all four protections against Shadow, Elemental, Normal and Piercing. A great first shield is the Wise Owlite Shield. It's a solid tank shield and it has maximum protection against Fire and Shock, which is especially useful for Vanaduke and Rauma's Twins. Now the eternal question, which sword to go for first? Obviously, one of the Brandish lines. Either Shock, Ice or Fire. Now most people go for Fire because, well, it's fire, nothing much to say there. It looks awesome and deals good damage. But personally, I'd suggest going for the Glacius, aka the Ice Brandish, because it proves to be very useful when doing Vanaduke. Fire not only has little damage there, but also it does no status effect. Last but not least, which gun should you get? Honestly, there is no argument here. You have to get Blitzneedle first. It is almost a must to complete Vanaduke without too many headaches. Now, after going over the basics, I'd also like to suggest some miscellaneous tips and hints, such as the importance of having friends in early and late game. Why is this important? Well, honestly, it isn't, but if you're playing a massively multiplayer game, one would think that friends are important. Friends can of course help you in missions and sometimes even in money management. Now if you have troubles here, I'd honestly suggest joining a guild so you get a ready-made package. Money management at the beginning. Now after doing all of the steps above, you're going to start to have some money problems. Imagining that your rank is knight or lower, I'd suggest the best thing to do is sell pet food you don't need on the auction halls. Other than that, you can farm the bosses you're capable of farming, preferably with friends. A lot of players get discouraged from the game at the beginning because of the endless grind the game demands, but trust me, that grind is easily solved with time and experience. Final thing you need to know before you're ready to start Spartan Lights is the auction house. The auction house is a place where all non-personal in-game trades take place. However, there are a few things you should be aware of. For example, when setting a price for one of these items, always check what the price is for the already existing offers. Here you can set your price to be a little cheaper and significantly boost your chances of a successful sell. But remember, other people can underprice your item as well. When choosing the time period for the auction house, honestly, I always choose very long, and I'd suggest for you to do the same. Here you give people more time to bid and you increase the number of people that see your items, since not everyone logs in every day. Finally, when you arrive in late game, you should start focusing on upgrading your weapon slots and trinket slots, so you increase your variability and durability in the game. Also focus on getting different armor sets such as Chaos set, which requires a lot of skill but can be devastating to the enemy. Alright guys, that's all from me. I hope this video helped you. Leave a like or a comment if you want to see me making more of this material, and subscribe to follow me. Have a wunderbar day.